Hello students, in this video I will explain gate insulated bipolar transistor, that is IGBT. IGBT combines the advantages of both BJT and power MOSFET. It has high input impedance like MOSFET and it has low on-state power loss as in BJT. Next is symbol of IGBT. There are three terminals, gate, emitter and collector, and it has input characteristic just like MOSFET and output characteristic just like BJT. Then equivalent circuit of IGBT. This equivalent circuit has MOSFET at the input side and BJT at the output side. Next is construction of IGBT. The structure of IGBT is shown in this figure. This is the layer structure or internal structure of IGBT. There are three terminals, collector, emitter and gate. P plus substrate is known as injection layer because it injects majority carrier holes in the N minus layer. This N minus layer is known as drift layer, and the thickness of N minus layer determines the voltage blocking capability of IGBT. This P region is known as body region, and these dash regions shows the metallic contact between semiconductor material and terminal. This is silicon dioxide layer, and gate is not connected with the internal structure of IGBT. It means that gate is insulated. So due to presence of silicon dioxide layer between gate and semiconductor material, a capacitance is generated between gate and semiconductor material. There are two junctions, J1 and J2. Next is working of IGBT. Suppose that collector is connected to the positive terminal of battery and emitter is connected to the negative terminal of battery, and there is no connection between gate and emitter. Then J1 junction, because this positive terminal is connected to P plus, then J1 junction is forward bias, J2 junction is reverse bias, and due to reverse biasing of this J2 junction, current will not flow from collector to emitter when gate to emitter voltage is zero. To start conduction, we apply a gate voltage. When we apply gate voltage, means positive is connected to gate terminal, negative is connected to emitter. Then a capacitor is induced in silicon dioxide layer just below the gate. This capacitance induces a channel in the P region or body region. Because of gate voltage, there will be negative ions at the gate side and positive ions at the semiconductor material side. These positive charge carriers of capacitance attracts minority carriers or negative charge carriers of P region just below the gate and makes the channel this. If we start increasing the gate potential, channel becomes stronger and the channel allows the flow of current from collector to the emitter. So to induce the channel, the gate voltage is sufficient or equal to or greater than threshold voltage. Now if VGE is equal to VGET, a large current flows from collector to emitter. This is the working of IGBT. Now I will explain the working of IGBT with the help of circuit diagram. In this circuit diagram, IG and VGE, these are the input current and input voltage, while IC and VCE are output current and output voltage. When we increase VG, IG increases means VG increases, and previously we see that when VG increases, junction is formed, channel is formed, sorry, and IC increases. Next is characteristic of IGBT. There are two characteristic, transfer characteristic and output characteristic. Transfer characteristic is drawn between IC and VGE. IC means output current and VG is input voltage. When VG is zero, no channel is formed, no current flows, and after increasing the value of VGE, at certain value of VGE, channel is formed and conduction starts flowing. And after that, when we increase the value of VG, IC increases. Next is output characteristic. Output characteristic is drawn between output current and output voltage. If VGE is zero, and if we increase the value of VCE, due to reverse biasing of junction J2, IC will be minimum, and this current is due to minority carrying, and this region is known as cutoff region. There is no conduction in IGBT. Now, if we increase the value of VGE, for higher value of VGE, channel is formed, so there will be a flow of current, and after increasing the voltage of the voltage will get saturated, and characteristic is like this. Let us say that this happens at VG1. If we further increase the value of VGE, there will be slightly higher amount of current, and characteristic will be like this. And let us say that this happens at VG2. So this is the output characteristic, and there are three reasons. Cutoff region, in which due to reverse biasing there is small current. This region is known as saturation region, and this region is known as active region. Thank you.